Shinto is the native religious tradition of Japan that began around the year 700. Unlike some religions, Shinto has no historical founder. Its roots lie deep in the prehistoric religious practices of the Japanese people. More than 100 million people around the world are Shintoists. The word Shinto means the way of kami. Kami are superior powers that Shintoists honor. They may be natural objects and creatures, such as the spirits of mountains and animals, worthy human beings such as emperors, or gods and goddesses.
Dressed in traditional white clothing, the men and women jogged around a shrine and chanted before lowering themselves into the freezing cold water. This purification ritual is a central tenet of Shinto, a Japanese religion that is as old as the country itself. So what exactly is Shinto? Well, it's the largest religion in Japan, practiced by an estimated 80% of the population. Back in the 6th century, indigenous Japanese people invented the word Shinto to distinguish their already existing faith from Buddhism, which was spreading throughout the region. Over time, Shinto and Buddhism came to coexist peacefully. Shinto is considered more a way of life rather than a specific set of beliefs or worship of a central deity. Most Japanese people identify as both Buddhist and Shinto. So how can someone follow two religions at once? Well, Shinto doesn't have many of the characteristics associated with religion. Unlike Christianity or Buddhism, it has no official founder or sacred text. Shinto does not try to explain the world in a sense of right and wrong, and thus there are no Shinto preachers or missionaries. The only goal of Shinto is to be in touch with kami, or spiritual energy, through sacred rituals. These include weddings, funerals, worship at a shrine or at home, and huge festivals. The word Shinto means way of kami. Kami is extremely complex, but basically they are sacred spirits that exist in earthy objects like mountains and trees, and in concepts like fertility. Kami also has an ancestral form, as humans become kami after they die. The sun goddess Amaterasu is the most important kami. In Japanese mythology, the royal family is thought to be descended from Amaterasu, beginning with the first emperor, Jimmu. It was thought that prayers and offerings to kami spirits at Shinto shrines and festivals will wash away evil spirits and thus purify a person or object. This process is the lifeblood of the Shinto practice, happening on a daily, weekly, seasonal, lunar, and annual basis. In fact, taking part in ritualistic worship and purification is the entirety of their faith. This has garnered criticism, as some liken Shinto worship to a performance rather than an act of devotion based on values and beliefs. Adherents to Shinto, however, think of rituals as a religious experience, one that binds a community together even more so than shared beliefs. Although Shinto is thousands of years old, it still has an active presence in Japanese life. For instance, new buildings are purified by a Shinto priest, and many Japanese-made cars are blessed during the assembly process. Japan's national sport, sumo, is directly derived from Shinto rituals, and symbols of purity can be found on the ring and on sumo garments. Many Japanese people keep a tiny shrine altar in their home, and local shrines play a huge role in communities, bringing people together for festivals and hosting weddings and funerals. Whether or not they identify as religious, virtually everyone in Japan is, in some sense, a part of Shinto. We can't do episodes like this without our sponsors, and this episode is brought to you by Dome.
Let's go pray. Let's go make a wish. Hey guys, welcome to the Japan A Ghost channel. My name is Chika. I am wearing a kimono today. I am going to my first hatsumode. So hatsu means first, and mode comes from moderu, which means to worship at a shrine. And it's actually my first time doing hatsumode, so it's actually my hatsumode. And we are at Meiji Jingu. The kimono that I have on is of a pattern that you wear for New Year's called takarazukushi. So it has lots of motifs that represent good luck, engi ga ii, as I told you guys in my last video. Here is the main torii, the main gate. and I'm gonna go in there and wish for a great year. This is basically a gate that separates people from the gods. So before entering, you wanna take a bow and you wanna walk along the side rather than in the middle, because the middle is God's path. I'm gonna take a bow. I'm in the sacred land. Alright, we've got another gate. Take a nice bow and we're gonna enter. Go in. People usually go to Hatsumode, their first shrine visit of the year, on the first, second, third, fourth, the first 4 days of the new year. But I've decided to go a little later because it gets crazy crowded the first 4 days. I think this year they made a record of 3 million people at just this shrine at Meiji Jingu. So it's ridiculous. All right, so before we go and pray, you have to wash your hands at this place. It's called Temizu. And there's a right way to do this. You don't just go in and wash it however you want. So I'll show you guys. Water is pretty cold, but you gotta do this before you go in and pray. And you guys saw that I wash my left first, right, and then you take a little bit of water in your hand and you rinse your mouth. And then you're ready to go pray. So let's go. A goendama. This is by Ben. It's good to put one of these in because goen means good luck. There's a proper way to pray. So you bow twice, you clap twice, and then you bow once. You want to make sure when you clap your hands that you move your right hand slightly lower and then clap and then put it back. And that's how you do it at most Shinto shrines, and it's different if you go to a temple. And there's some variations depending on where you go. Okay, so we can't film, so I'm just gonna go do this. I prayed. Next, I'm gonna get an omikuji. If you've seen my other video, I talk about it, but it's basically a fortune or an oracle, and let's hope we get the best one. And you can usually get them for 100 yen. So here we go. We have an English one and a Japanese one. I'm gonna get the English one for you guys so you understand. Not because I can't read Japanese. Doki doki. You know that onomatopoeia? Doki doki. Means your heart's beating. You're nervous. Doesn't have my thing on here. So I got my omikuji, my fortune, and I was expecting to get, well, I wanted daikichi, but one of those, the 12 ranks or so that I explained about before. But at Meiji Jingu, you don't get a rank, you get a poem. And the poem, basically, there's different kinds of poems in there, and that kind of symbolizes what your year is going to be. And so I'll read you guys my poem. Let's see. It says, "If we falter in resolve just because the task is hard, no accomplishment can follow. It is the world's way." Emperor Meiji. I guess I have some trials and tribulations coming my way, but I won't give up, and I'll keep trying. My good luck charm for becoming a YouTuber. Every year you come and get a new charm, and then the next year when you get a new charm, you want to bring your old one, and they'll burn it for you. This is called an emma. As you'll see, there's lots of them around me, and you write a wish on this side, and then you hang it up and hope it comes true. So my hands are freezing cold, so I could barely write, but I wrote, "I wish all those around me that I love are happy and healthy, and I hope to make people around the world happy with my YouTube videos." January 16th, 2014. Chica. Very top. Hey. I had a very good Hatsumode. I hope you guys got to enjoy a little bit of it yourselves and understand what Hatsumode is all about. And I am going to leave the gate now. So take another bow and leave.